Alright, this match with four color rites. We're gonna keep this hand. We're gonna immediately get a green. Drop a thing. Man, remember when we had fetch lands and you didn't have to deal with all this, like, lands coming into play tapped? Insta green. Man, so many, it's so funny how many decks are playing Evolving Wilds, too. Are we just gonna play mono, like, mono Zulaport Cutthroat decks? Zulaport Cutthroat until I die. Alright, so we're just gonna play Elvish Visionary here. Okay, stack really needs to go up here. There we go. Oh, we hit a land. That's great. So next time we can go green, land rights, play the land, play Dryad maybe. Yep, just mono rights decks all the way down. So green, this guy, cryptolithic right, also writing those wrongs, and we'll just play Dryad here because it's all we can do. It's all I can do. And there's a cutthroat, your favorite and mine. Just kidding, he's not anybody's favorite. Alright, so we do have 6 mana, which is pretty sweet. We can actually Catacomb Sifter and then keep up Collected Company. That seems good, right? 1, 2, 3. Get busy sifting or get busy dying, that's what I always say. I think we're just going to bounce the cutthroat, though. He probably has... we have to assume he has Collected Company because he kept these two up and these two up. 3 cards... One is probably a Collected Company. He's probably going to respond to this with Collected Company, which doesn't really make a lot of sense, I don't think, but that's fine. You got to do what you got to do. I guess if you got a... Here we go, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Who saw that coming? No one, apparently. No one but me. Two Zulaport Cutthroats. Wow. And you have one in hand. So apparently we're literally just facing mono decks that can draw 3 Zulaport Cutthroats in this format. Wow. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. What in the earth is even happening here? Is this real life? I have no idea what's happening. It's funny because Seth Manfield actually said this is the best matchup for us. If we don't die here, we might be fine, but I don't know if that's an option. Like, if we don't die here, we just Westvale Abbey, right? Which seems good. We know he has a cutthroat in hand. Alright, well. These have been some very, very solid, solid Collected Companies from you. I am flabbergasted. Yep. Sacrifice Loam Dryad, huh? Why not the Blister Pod? Why you sacrifice a 1/2 instead of a 2 and instead of a 1/1 that also gives you something when it dies? I don't understand. Maybe there's a reason. Yep, that guy's big, sure. Yeah, it's fine. We'll discard Catacomb Sifter. So, we can't cast anything here. I feel like we just bounce this guy. We kind of don't want Nantuko Husk in life. So now we know he has Husk Cutthroat. Do we just get Ormondal and kill Liliana? He can't replay Husk next turn is really the thing.
So he literally is going to have one option. And if we just play Ormondal, it seems insane. Yep, he just actually sacrificed that guy. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. We actually have to keep a guy around, too. One, two, three, four, five. It seems fine, actually. We could probably keep Sifter around, because it's just better than Mage if we get... Actually, Mage might just be better. Is it just Ormondal here? What does she do? Return a non-legendary dark creature with confirmed mana. Yeah, we're just going to have to kill her, because otherwise he gets Husk back, and that's just bad. One, two, three, four. It's not realistic to actually... One, two, three, four. We'd have one, two, three, four. It's not realistic to play Collected Company and Westvale Abbey. We'd have to hope to hit, like literal Catacomb Sifter. One, two... Oh, that's not what we wanted to do at all. Alright, so... Two... Three, four... Alright, so... One, two, three, four... Five... Sacrifice five dudes. One, two, three, four, five... Get a lot of scries here, which is kind of nice. Unfortunately, we don't... bottom. And bottom again. And... You're not going to do anything at this point, unfortunately. And we're just going to bottom everything. Attack Liliana. We'll gain 7. That seems good. I'm okay with this course of action here. We still have a Collected Company. We know he has a Cutthroat in hand, which is obnoxious, but not the end of the world, especially when we gain 9 each turn. Yep, we now know nothing in your hand. You can see how good Cryptolith Rite is. I'm surprised. Yep, Loam Dryad also not great. I will block and kill whoever you... Yeah, that's just fine. Yep, 9, yeah. So, 2 turn clock after this. Probably gonna get a white here just so we have all our colors. Another Loam Dryad. Not really terrifying, I'll be honest with you. Let's see what we hit. Okay, well, Displacer and Reflector Mage, let's say. And that's the end. Alright, sweet. Good to know. Man. Despite the triple cutthroats we're facing, this worked out pretty well. So 2 visionaries get cut. We bring in Enlightened Ascetic and Ultimate Price. Ultimate Price seems pretty good. 1 Ultimate Price is just fine, I guess. All right. Let's try it again. All right. We're going to keep this hand. I think it's just fine. We have turn 1 Loam Dryad. We don't have a turn 2 play, unfortunately, but I have faith. We're also on the draw here, so... Could work out. Oh, alright. No turn 1 play from him either, though, so I feel pretty okay with that. Loam Dryad. Get them Loam Dryad beats on there. Now we don't have to take 2 damage from Catacomb Sifter, which is nice. We do have Catacomb into Collected Company, so depending on how slow his start is, we could actually be fine. Eldrazi Displacer. Also a good dude, but we do not have an, a white mana yet. Of course, if we go Sifter next turn, 1, 2, 3, Sifter, we can go this guy, tap the Sifter, and sack the token for 2 mana. You could see, again, like I keep saying it, but you can definitely see the importance of Rites in this matchup. Let's just go Westvale Abbey. Take another damage. Also, Eldrazi Displacer is great if Nantuko Husk is just trying to attack you to death. Which is not super common, but... That guy is very good, but we're just going to bounce him to Oblivion. Just attack with Nantuko Husk and then sack Kalidus to trade with a Catacomb Sifter? That seems terrible, right? I would 100% block, just so you know. What? Is he really considering it? No way. Okay. It's like, there's no way you're doing that. So we are going to go blue, colorless. And this guy to bounce your stupid Kalidus.
He's called Kalitas.
Yeah, I actually don't know how to pronounce that dude's name, so. Bounce this bro. Get in there. God, again, one more mana and we'd be great, but we don't actually have a white, so we couldn't play Displacer here. Next turn we can play Collected Company. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We can actually play Displacer and Collected Company if we don't mind. Well, now I have to assume he has Collected Company here. That's what we wanted. All right, we're going to play Displacer first. 1, 2, 3. Because I kind of want to have this guy out for any shenanigans. Like if he tries to block with Husk or something and then pump it a million times, we can blink it. We can also just blink Husk now. 1, 2. Tap something for 3. We don't have to do that, though. Like, Husk doesn't present a problem right now. Here we go. Yep. Kalidus in hand, we know that much. Can you just whiff and get 2 crappy creatures? Or not, no creatures at all, maybe? Is that too much to ask? The fact that this deck has access to Reflector Mage and Eldrazi Displacer is pretty legit. That's a good dude. 2 great tastes that taste great together. Just... the old double block, eh? I will... Pretty sure we just trade 1 for 1, right? Yeah, that seems fine. As soon as we blink this guy, he's just going to pump the first one with it, so it doesn't really do anything. And we still have Collected Company mana, which is pretty nice. We can also just blink the stupid Nantuko Husk, which I feel like is pretty good. Or we blink the Recruit, he plays Kalidus. Yeah, we're just going to blink the Recruit, actually. I don't really care about Collected Company here. Oh, that's not what we wanted to do. Arrgh! Oh, we misclicked. We were going to click the stupid Reflector Mage. My whole point was to get this guy back in the hand, so I'm like, what guy am I blinking? This guy. Oh, that was stupid. That's something that would never happen in real life. Like, that's literally just disconnect between brain and hand. Oh, that's so bad. That's actually fine, because he doesn't have anything else. Yeah, that's... Arrgh, I'm so disappointed in myself for that. He would have 1 less guy. Then we could bounce Kalidus, and it's just very good for us. I'm so mad at myself. Right now, we can just blink, bounce, bounce. Now we're gonna do it right. Doubt you have a removal spell. Kalidus in hand. Oh my god, I did it again! Well, that's twice. Ugh. Alright, anyway. Man, the misclicks are real. So, if we did this correctly, he just wouldn't have been able to play this guy either. Ugh. Yeah, Reflector Mage, why? Yeah, we'll take two here. And then we'll just bounce your team again. I hope. Man, misclicks are super real. Wow, he wouldn't... Oh, he's just activating. Okay, sure. He gets a sifter. That's fine. So we now have a Kalidus and a sifter in hand. So we can actually go... Black this guy. Tap one. Kill this guy. Oh, I guess he's just gonna scoop. All right, he knows. I think he just knows we've got Eldrazi lock on him. So, all right. Well, that was just fine for us, I guess.